may be seated. Welcome to Washburn University and the 110th graduation ceremony of Washburn University School of Law. I am Aida Alica, the Associate Dean for Academic Affairs. I would like to introduce the members of the platform party. Beginning on my left, they are Dr. Randy Pembroke, Vice President for Academic Affairs, Washburn University. Jalen Lowry, Law School alumna and Associate Dean for Student Affairs. Sabrina Standifer, Law School alumna and President of Washburn University School of Law Alumni Association. Brent Bowles, Board of Regents member. Paul Hoferer, Law School alumnus, Board of Regents member, and past president of the Washburn University School of Law Alumni Association. Pam O'Toole Truesdale, Law School alumna and Vice Chair, Board of Regents. Blanche Parks, Board of Regents member. Jennifer Sork, Law School alumna and Chair, Board of Regents. George Barton, Law School alumnus, honorary degree recipient, and our speaker this evening. Thomas Romig, Dean of the Law School. And Dr. Jerry Farley, President of Washburn University. For the faculty and staff of Washburn University School of Law, this is really a somewhat bittersweet day. We remember how just 3 years ago, most of you, the members of the class of 2015, were filled with anticipation and perhaps a little bit of dread when you prepared to commence the study of law. And just 1 year ago, we prepared to welcome our very first LLM student. It seems like time has gone by very quickly. Today, you are prepared to commence the practice of law. Your journey to this day required hard work and dedication, but I know that you have made lasting friendships with Washburn Law faculty and staff, as well as your colleagues with whom you worked to obtain the skills and values of the legal profession. Your journey to this day has also had its share of laughs and fun, if the faculty roast during the bar review is any indication. Now, after working so hard and achieving so much, you should be filled with pride and excitement as you move on with your professional lives. This is a day of celebration. This is your day. I know that I speak for all of the faculty, my fellow administrators, all of the law school staff, the university, and the Board of Regents, our special guests, and your family and friends who are with you here this evening in offering you our congratulations on a job well done. Although we will miss you, we wish you the very best with your careers and personal lives. We could not be more proud of you. Please keep in touch. We are always happy to hear from you. I would now like to introduce you to the Associate Dean for Student Affairs, Jalen Lowry.
Dear class of 2015, it's very exciting to see you making the transition from law students to colleagues. I have the pleasure tonight of introducing to your loved ones the president that you elected as the leader of your Washburn Student Bar Association. President Tabitha Chapman, come on up, has been very active in the law school and also outside the school. She was former president of the Washburn Law Pro Bono Society, intern for the Death Penalty Advisory Committee of the Kansas Judicial Council, was selected as a Washburn nominee for the ABA Pro Bono Award, served every year as a Washburn Law Ambassador, and is the Executive Lieutenant Governor for the ABA Law School Division, 8th Circuit. President Chapman plans on moving to Washington, D.C. after graduation, where she has worked the last two summers for the United States Court of Appeals for the Armed Forces. She has been of great service to the law students, to the school, and to the community, and we are proud to call her our own. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming President Tabitha Chapman.
Thank you, Dean Lowry, for making me sound way more awesome than I actually am. I am going to be honest, this is only slightly more intimidating than maybe a Professor K cold call. So thank you for the opportunity. Good evening, deans, professors, graduates, and friends and family. I find it fitting that this is the law school class to graduate on Washburn's 150th anniversary. The university was founded on the principle that all people, regardless of race, gender, ethnicity, and income, have the right to an education. And this class I have seen exemplify that principle from the many first-year or first-generation college graduates like myself to the single parents and the students who left 20-year careers to pursue law. I've actually have some friends that are small-town Kansas farmers and also Washburn legacies, and we have a very diverse class, and if we take a moment to look at our past and see how far we've come from that, we've all come a very long way, but we each grew personally, but also together. We brought those diverse experiences and we formed a family. We really did make friendships that will last a lifetime. Excuse me. When we do look back on this experience, we may not remember the libation station sandwiches or the lack thereof. We may not remember the frigid room temperatures or the parking. Okay, we'll remember the parking. But we may not remember the cold calls or the missed points on the exams. But there's definitely one thing we're going to remember, and that's the amount of pizza that we ate within 3 years. So hold on to that in the future. And even though graduation is a time to reflect, let's also look to the future. We now have the skills to help those who need it most out in society. We do have the skills to make a difference. So let's take that Washburn legacy forward with us. Let's not forget all the people who suffered through the earth-shattering conversations on tort reform and rules against perpetuities or crying over exams or griping about cold calls. Our friends and family, we would not be here without them today. The people that cooked us meals when we just couldn't find the time or who supported us from afar, we really want to thank you for your support, and we were able to come together and suffer through it with the support of our friends and family. And none of us also would be here today without the help and the dedication from the professors. Washburn has a very unique atmosphere where the professors really do care. They really do reach out to the students. And we quickly formed mentorships with those professors. So we thank you all for going the extra mile and supporting us in ways we don't even know about. So with that, it's now my honor to present the William O. Douglas Professor and Adjunct Professor of the Year Awards. These awards provide an opportunity to recognize outstanding instructors who motivate, challenge, and inspire excellence in the students, and who are respected by the students and peers alike. Each year, the graduating class votes on professors they feel have made a significant impact on their educational experience. So the recipient of the Adjunct Professor of the Year Award this year is Professor Ron Dees. Ron Dees is currently the Assistant Director of Academic Skills in Bar Passage. After graduating from Washburn Law, Professor Dees practiced in family law and estate planning. He returned to Washburn as an Institute for Law Teaching and Learning Fellow to assist in developing the Washburn Bar Pass program. Professor Dees teaches mastering legal analysis to many of the graduating 1Ls or 3Ls in their last year of school. So I would like to present the Adjunct Professor of the Year Award to Ronald Dees. And for this year's recipient of the Professor of the Year Award is Andrea Boyack. Professor Boyack has an extensive background practicing teaching and writing on legal topics and contracts and property law. Prior to coming to Washburn, Professor Boyack practiced corporate finance and real estate in Washington, D.C. and New York City. She's currently co-director of the Washburn Business and Transactional Law Center and has participated in Commercial Law Project, which Washburn shares with the Republic of Georgia. On behalf of the class of 2015, I'd like to thank you for your dedication to our success. Congratulations, Professor Boyack. And again, a big thank you to the professors for all you've done for us through the 3 years that we've been here. And to the graduates, it's been my absolute pleasure to share the last 3 years with you. For so many reasons, I know that coming to Washburn was the right place for me, and there's no other group of people that I'd rather call my colleagues and peers. So thank you for everything that we have done for each other. Thank you for this opportunity to speak today, so let's go study for the bar.
Thank you, Ms. Chapman. Speaking on behalf of the Washburn University School of Law Alumni Association is graduate and president of the Alumni Association Board of Governors, Sabrina Standifer.
Good evening. I think they expected a much taller person. I'm literally standing on my tiptoes at this point. It'll be good for me. On behalf of the Washburn University School of Law Alumni Association, congratulations to the graduating class of 2015. I can remember sitting where you are tonight and having such a mixture of emotions. There was happiness, there was relief, pride, dread about the upcoming bar, and also just being grateful that all of my friends and family were here with me to celebrate. I mean, look at these people here with you. That's just great. As a Washburn graduate, you now join more than 7,200 alumni around the world. Your degree opens up so many doors to so many opportunities, whether it be as a private practice attorney, in government service, as an attorney in-house with a company, or as a politician, and that's just to name a few. This celebration marks the completion of a rigorous course of study and the beginning of your career as a Washburn lawyer, not just a lawyer, but a Washburn lawyer. As a lawyer, your clients are going to rely on your advice. They will trust you with their finances and their freedom. And when you leave here, remember that as you meet people, you are representing the legal profession and Washburn, and it is up to each of us to make a positive impression. I've always said that attending Washburn was one of the best decisions I ever made in my life. I get to do work that I truly enjoy, that is satisfying, and that is challenging. The Alumni Association presents various awards each year, and a recurring theme when recipients are accepting their awards is when they talk about what a difference Washburn Law School has made in not only their lives, but also in the lives of their families. What an amazing institution. Since opening its doors in 1903, Washburn Law has consistently graduated some of the finest lawyers in the country, lawyers who set the highest standards in legal skills, ethical character, and leadership. As a matter of fact, two of our alumni are here tonight from the class of 1965. These golden alumni are celebrating their 50th Washburn Law School reunion, and we are so honored that they have joined us. I would like to recognize these alumni and ask that they stand as I call out their names. From the class of 1965, John Hamilton and Ed Soule. Let's give them a round of applause. As these gentlemen will tell you, you will encounter many challenges throughout your career. Meet these challenges with character and professionalism. And I also hope that you will remember to pay it forward and help those students coming after you at Washburn. That's why I'm here tonight, and you will find that spirit in your fellow Washburn alumni. Be an ambassador for the law school. Recommend prospective students. Serve as a guest lecturer. Please join and become active in the Alumni Association. Your involvement will help Washburn Law continue to grow and will ensure that future classes will be proud to join us as an alum. Tonight, your Law School Alumni Association will be giving you a bronze medallion bearing the Washburn seal. We hope this token will remind you that you now represent the tradition of excellence carried on by more than 100 years of Washburn lawyers. Again, on behalf of the School of Law Alumni Association, our best wishes to you for a long and successful career. And now, it is my privilege to introduce the Dean of our law school, Thomas J. Roman.
Thank you, Sabrina. Good evening and welcome to the 110th graduation ceremony of Washburn University School of Law. On behalf of the faculty and the staff of the law school, congratulations to you, the class of 2015. This is truly a time for celebration. Each of you has worked very hard to reach this moment, and you should be justly proud of your achievement. I hope you take time to reflect on how far you've come these past 3 years. I also hope you take the opportunity to thank those who have helped you reach this grand moment. Your family, your friends who supported you throughout this journey, and the law school faculty and staff that provided you instruction and guidance while you were here. Every class that passes through the halls of our law school is unique in its own way. And this is certainly true of your class, the class of 2015. As you know, you're graduating on the 150th anniversary of the establishment of Washburn University. In recognition of the impact that Washburn University and Washburn University School of Law have had around the world, we have flags of the countries of students who have attended both Washburn and Washburn School of Law, both sides and above us. Your graduating class will be the first class to have a Master's of Law degree awarded by the law school. Your class has 18 members who have relatives who are also Washburn Law alums. Several of you have multiple relatives who are Washburn alumni, and two of you are third-generation Washburn Law graduates, as you are following in the path of your fathers and grandfathers. During your time at Washburn Law, there have been 21 students in your class that have been married or have gotten engaged, including three couples who are graduating together tonight. There have been 13 babies born to your class. And there are six more that we know of on the way. These are records that I'm sure will stand the test of time. One of your classmates, Nathan Unruh, will be unable to walk tonight because of an immediate family member had a medical emergency taking him to that family member. and we'll keep Nathan and his family in our thoughts. In your time at Washburn Law, you not only worked hard in and out of the classroom, but you were also involved in the student organizations and the activities that contributes in so many ways to the life of the law school community. And while you were here, you made friends that will last you for a lifetime. As was mentioned at the bar review in March, you came in as strangers and you are leaving as friends and family. This ceremony recognizes that you have not only earned a highly respected degree, but you have transitioned into the profession of law. This will distinguish you for the rest of your lives. You will be lawyers, Washburn lawyers. There will be many opportunities that will be open to you, and as you will find, there are many interesting and important things you can do with your law degree. The skills you have learned, your ability to analyze issues, organize and effectively communicate your thoughts, and to solve problems will serve you well in any situation. In short, you have learned to think like lawyers. In a few moments, you will become part of that great tradition, one of the great traditions of the legal profession. You will join the distinguished line of Washburn Law graduates. As you go forward from here, you will begin to add to our legacy and to the reputation of Washburn Law. So be proud of your lineage, serve your profession and our great law school well. And as you set out on your careers, a final word of advice from your old dean. Make sure that you have balance in your life. It was important in law school, but it will become even more important as you go forward in your careers. And just remember, there is no record of anyone on their deathbed uttering these final words. Gee, I wish I'd spent more time in the office. And now it is my honor and privilege to introduce this year's commencement speaker, George A. Barton. The commencement program has George's biography, and rather than repeat it, I'm going to touch upon some of the highlights of his very distinguished career. George graduated cum laude with a Bachelor of Arts degree in English from the University of Pennsylvania in 1973. He earned his Juris Doctor from Washburn University School of Law in 1977, graduating magna cum laude. While at Washburn Law, George was the executive editor of Volume 16 of the Washburn Law Journal. George has practiced law in Kansas City for 38 years, where he established himself as a nationally recognized plaintiff's attorney. Since 1998, he has been the principal in the law offices of George A. Barton, PC, which specializes in complex business litigation. He has devoted the majority of his practice to representing mineral interest owners in royalty underpayment litigation against natural gas producers in Colorado, Kansas, and Oklahoma. George has been a frequent guest lecturer at the law school on all aspects of business litigation. He was selected by Washburn University as the Law School Alumni Fellow in 2011. This honor, the Alumni Fellow, is awarded to alumni who have distinguished themselves in their careers. George is a member of the Washburn University Board Foundation Board of Trustees and is on the board of directors of that organization. He and his wife, Teresa, have two children and one grandchild. Please join me in welcoming a distinguished graduate and a tremendous supporter of Washburn University School of Law, your commencement speaker, George A. Barton.
Thank you, Dean Roman. And I also want to thank the Board of Regents and Dr. Farley for bestowing this very rare honor on me and for giving me the opportunity to address the 2015 graduating class of the law school. I want to add my congratulations to the 122 individuals who are receiving their Juris Doctor degree tonight. I know from being a graduate of this law school how hard you've worked, how much time and effort you've invested, and you should be very proud of that achievement. What is exciting for each of you tonight is that you are going to embark on your full-time legal career now that you're graduating from law school. And that's a very significant point in your life. You now have the opportunity to use your legal education, and you're going to go out and you're going to embark on your first full-time job out of law school. And most of you, as you sit here tonight, have a pretty good idea of what your first full-time law job is going to be. You know that you're going to be what type of law work you're going to do, whether it's a county prosecutor, a criminal defense lawyer, a civil litigation lawyer, or a business lawyer. And that job, as you go into a full-time career, is a very exciting opportunity for a young graduate from law school, because you're going to be able to begin to develop the skills and the expertise that is going to permit you to represent clients in resolving and solving their real-world problems. You're going to have the opportunity to go into a courtroom and appear in front of a judge and argue cases in front of the court. You're going to have an opportunity to prepare briefs. You're going to have the opportunity to represent clients in business transactions. And all of this sounds very exciting, but it's also a challenge, because your first year, or first 5 years out of law school, you're still in the learning process. You're still trying to learn to develop the kind of expertise that you ultimately want to have. But as you go into your very first job out of law school, there's a couple of objectives that I want to have you consider. Because ultimately, when you take this first job out of law school, that's probably not going to be the type of law work that you ultimately may best fit your skills, your desires, your ambitions. So you need to take some time to consider this question. What kind of lawyer do I ultimately want to be? And that's a tough question when you first get out of law school. But you have two significant advantages I would suggest to you. The first is that your professors at this law school have given you an absolutely excellent legal education that enables you to compete with anybody. You have the kind of education that gives you the opportunity to go into just about any type of legal practice or specialty that you choose to pursue. And the second advantage that you have is that there are so many different types of areas of practice, and there are so many different specialties that are opportunities for you and where good young lawyers are needed. During the 38 years that I've been practicing law in Kansas City, I have seen my colleagues and my classmates develop specialties, develop excellent careers in so many different types of fields. I have seen lawyers develop specialties in immigration, in adoption, in divorce, in mergers and acquisitions, in aviation law, in becoming a mediator or an arbitrator for resolving civil disputes, in, like myself, dealing with oil and gas law, intellectual property, copyright law, and becoming trial judges. And I even have one classmate who's become an excellent law professor, who happens to be a law professor at this very university. So there are all kinds of specialties that are available to you. So what you need to do is, when you're in your first job, you need to take time and search out the kind of specialty, the kinds of areas of practice that are going to be of interest to you. You need to give consideration to talking to lawyers that are involved in the areas of practice that are of interest to you. Seek out those lawyers. Most of those lawyers will be happy to spend time with you and tell you about their area of practice and how they got involved in it. Take the time to become involved in a bar association committee or other organization that's involved in a particular area of practice that's of interest to you. Take the time to subscribe to and read periodically all of the lawyer blogs that are out there on the internet that are terrific educational sources for all kinds of different specialties. There are three that I read regularly. One of them is called the litigationandtrial.com. It's excellent. Another is called lawpros.org. Another is the SCOTUS on the law, which is the Supreme Court blog, which is excellent. But there are many, many others for you to consider, and there are many, many specialties that I haven't even touched the surface on. I think it's important for you to do that. There are some real-life reasons why you need to take the time to think about the bigger picture. Because realistically, when you take your first job out of law school, you're going to be doing things that are going to be dictated by your employer. And that's understandable. For example, if you go to a law firm, you're going to be doing the work that fits the needs of the law firm's clients. And you can't blame the law firm for that, because the ultimate objective of every law firm is to serve its clients. But ultimately, you're not necessarily going to be doing the type of legal work that you ultimately aspire to. So you've got to take the time to develop your own game plan about what kind of law practice, what kind of law career you really want to have. And that's not the easiest thing to do when you're a young lawyer, because you're trying to satisfy your employer, you're trying to develop your skills for the cases that you have or the business transactions that you have. But I'm going to sit here and tell you tonight that it's probably the most important thing you can do, because there are so many opportunities out there and so many opportunities. When I hear people say, well, it's a tough job market out there, to some extent that's true for young lawyers, but there are also all kinds of opportunities that are available if you make the commitment to it and you develop a good game plan for working yourself into that type of practice. And I think it's critically important that each of you consider that. Ultimately, you do not want someone else deciding for you what type of legal career you want to have. You don't want somebody else, whether it be an employer, it be circumstance, it be family situation or anything else, depriving you of working your way up to the type of legal career, the type of area of practice that you ultimately want to have. Now, to be sure, as you execute that game plan and develop that game plan, there are going to be plenty of roadblocks and obstacles that stand in your path. Not the least of which is that there are short-term financial considerations that you have to consider anytime you're trying to develop your career, anytime you're trying to move into a new area of practice. But my suggestion to you is, don't let the short-term financial considerations stand in the way of you pursuing the type of legal career that you want to have. You've got to persist and work your way up to and into the type of practice, the area of practice, the type of legal career that you ultimately want to have. And I can tell you from my own experience, you should not let artificial considerations limit your considerations. I've been practicing law in Kansas City for 38 years, and my law office has always been in Kansas City. But I've never turned down an opportunity to take on an interesting case, even though that case may have been way outside of Kansas City and somewhat of an inconvenient location to litigate cases in. One of the most important cases of my career was a royalty payment dispute that I had to litigate in Yuma, Colorado. Yuma, Colorado, for anybody that happens to know where it is in eastern Colorado, and from the perspective of somebody who lives in Kansas City, it's in the middle of nowhere. And I had to go out there 25 times during the course of that litigation. But I'll tell you something, it turned out to be one of the most important cases that I ever had a chance to be involved in my entire career. And the fact that I made the effort to litigate that case that was not geographically desirable turned out to be very, very important to me. And I would say the same thing to you. There's nothing about where you have your law practice, where you live, that in any way should diminish your opportunities. I've had the opportunity to litigate cases in New York, North Carolina, Oklahoma, Indiana, Kentucky, California, Colorado, Oklahoma, and New Mexico. And every time I've done it, I've been glad for the experience. I've been glad for the experience. And I recommend that you take the same perspective. And I can tell you that when I took on these responsibilities, these trial responsibilities in unusual locations, I always felt I was qualified to do it. And I think you've got the kind of educational background that you've gotten at this law school that makes every single one of you capable of pursuing any type of legal career that you want to pursue. But you got to make the commitment to do it, and you've got to give consideration to what it is that you really want to do. And you cannot be bogged down by short-term considerations. You've got to look at the bigger picture. It is so important as a young lawyer to stay abreast of what the developing trends in the law are. What are the cases, what are the types of cases that are developing throughout the country? What are the types of business issues that are developing throughout the country? The more you engage in that kind of process, the better off you're going to be. I can tell you that in my practice, 38 years, my best experiences have come when I've reached out to try to do something that maybe was a little difficult from the outset, but which in the long run was rewarding. And that's what I would recommend each and every one of you to consider. And ultimately, if you do that and you take that objective, I think you will have a more rewarding career in the long run. And ultimately, I think that's going to give you the best opportunity to be effective in representing your clients and getting the best results. And that's the other thing I want to talk about tonight. I think when you're out there as a young practicing lawyer, there's one particular objective that you don't want to lose sight of. The ultimate purpose of a lawyer, in my opinion, is to do everything you can to give your client the best representation possible within the bounds of the law. And that's a big undertaking. That's a big responsibility. But that's, as lawyers, what we owe to the clients. And I think if you focus in on that and do it professionally, within the bounds of the law, within the rules of ethics, and making arguments on behalf of those clients that are well-grounded in the law, that ultimately you will have a very, very successful legal career. And my hope tonight, as I sit here and address you, is that each and every one of the 122 graduates of the 2015 School of Law, that you reach your full potential, and that you find your niche or area of the law that best fits your skills, your ambitions, and your desires. And I congratulate all of you for being graduates of the Washburn Law School, and thank you for giving me the time to speak to you tonight.
Be it known that inasmuch as honorary degrees are awarded to men and women who, because of scholarly contributions, notorious public service, or other noteworthy achievements, have become to universal high regard, the Board of Regents of Washburn University does therefore confer upon Mr. George Barton the degree of Doctor of Law with all the rights, privileges, and insignia pertaining thereto. In testimony whereof, this diploma is issued with the signatures of the President and the Chair of the Board of Regents and the seal of the University affixed in Topeka, Kansas on the 16th day of May, 2015.
Thank you.
Mr. Barton, your leadership, your support of higher education, and your dedication to helping others Washburn University honors you in itself by conferring upon you this honorary degree. In token thereof, I cause you to be vested with the Doctor of Law academic hood and grant you this diploma.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Will the candidate for the Master of Laws degree please rise? Dean Romick, President Farley, I present to you the candidate for the Master of Laws degree of the class of 2015.
President Farley, the candidate before you is expected to complete all requirements for the Master of Laws degree and has been recommended by the Faculty of Law. I am pleased to present him to you now for the conferring of his degree. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of Washburn University, I hereby convey upon you the degree Master's of Law, with all of the rights, honors, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Will you move your tassel from the right side to the left side? If you would now come forward and join us as we bestow the degree upon you.
Ronald Robert Manieri.
Absentia have completed or are expected to complete all requirements for the Juris Doctor degree and have been recommended by the Faculty of Law. I am pleased to present them to you now for conferring of their degrees. Thank you, Dean Romick. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of Washburn University, I hereby confer upon those who have or will complete the requirements the degree Juris Doctor, with all of the rights, honors, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. As a symbol of this great achievement, I ask that you now move your tassel from the right side to the left side of your caps. Congratulations, graduates. Would you please come forward as directed to receive your diplomas?
Honors announced at this ceremony are preliminary. Mohammed Aziz Abdelaziz. Lindsay Adele Acton. Jeremy Atkinson. Jeffrey Michael Paul Aiken, Dean's Honor. Caitlin Elizabeth Alegria. Nora Christine Avalon, Dean's Honor. Justin David Bignell. Elizabeth Ann Billinger. Amelia Erin Brown. Jesse Andrew Burris. Mark Allen Campbell, Dean's Honor. Rachel Adrienne Catlett. Tabitha Nicole Chapman. Jordan Reed Closier, Dean's Honors. Chaz Andrew Coberly, Dean's Honors. Thomas Chesterfield Compton, Dean's Honors. Jessica Fiorini Conroe, Dean's Honors. Kevin B. Coombs. Christina J. Crawford. Bethany Leanne Crossland. Michelle K. David. Dylan Matthew Dinkla. Jennifer Kilpatrick Dorman, Dean's Honors. Michael Adam Dunbar, Dean's Honors. Candace Yasmin Farha. Evan Ross Freeman. Meredith Marie Fry. Jessica Nicole Gallagher. Benjamin Paul Good. Juan Pablo Gordillo. David Lamar Gross. Kyle David Hamilton, Dean's Honor. Jennifer Harper. Gabrielle Blythe Martin Ilaria, cum laude. Skipper C. Jacobs, Dean's Honors. Raymond James. Nathan Ascott Jewenball. Samuel Warren Jones. Melissa Jane Jordan. Seth Michael Yurchik, Dean's Honors. Cameron Clark Justice. Courtney Louise Kelly, Dean's Honors. Janae Jean Kent. Grant Douglas Kleist, magna cum laude. Jacob Todd Knight, Dean's Honors. Michael Kolich, Dean's Honors. Taylor Renee Kramer, Dean's Honors. Benjamin Scott Lamb. Grace Ann Lancaster. Jennifer Dawn Laudermilk. Roger Gordon Ludke. Eric Gerhard Lauren Mai. Michaela Nicole Marine. Jacob Matthew Mark, cum laude. Jonathan Hartford Mathis, cum laude. Sarah Catherine Maupin, Dean's Honors. Jordan Lee May, magna cum laude. Matthew Christopher McInerney, magna cum laude. Jason Glenn McElrath. Kyle Campbell McCray. Megan Michelle Metzinger. Chase Lee Miller. Matthew David Moore. Aaron Michael Osmer. Richard Roger Ottinger, Dean's Honors. Olatoye Oyelowo. Danielle Nicole Packer. Brian Verdell Payne, magna cum laude. Christopher Donovan Philippi, Dean's Honors. Allie Janae Prester, Dean's Honors. Brett Micah Robinson. Alexander Otsuki Rodriguez, Dean's Honors. Kayla Lynn Raylor, Dean's Honors. Ashley Nicole Rolader. Warren Churick III. Kristen Lynn Seacrest. Dylan Ray Searle. Armand Leonidovich Shukayev. Richard William Smith. Carl Joseph Snyder. Christopher Robert Staley, cum laude. Cameron George Stark. Bradley Truman Steen, magna cum laude. Adil Akhtar Sayed, Dean's Honors. David Allen Thompson. Kara Lynn Tidwell.
I have a card for the Lynn Thompson. Lynn.
Megan Lynn Townsley. John Stephen Vetter, Dean's Honors. Kathleen Michelle Wary, cum laude. Wesley M. Weber. Rodney Ladarin Wilson. Allison Grace Wood. Coleman James Younger. Jason Andrew Zavadil, Dean's Honors. Kelly Sue Shorb.
Graduates, would you please stand? The Juris Doctor degree is the highest level of professional attainment in the School of Law and represents 90 academic credit hours of advanced study in law. The Master of Laws degree represents an additional 24 academic credit hours of advanced study in law. We are proud to welcome 121 Juris Doctor graduates and one Master of Laws degree graduate as new alumni to the School of Law and Washburn University. On behalf of the entire university and Washburn University School of Law, I wish to thank you for participating in this exercise, this commencement exercise. Please join us in the Washburn Room of the Memorial Union for a reception. President Farley, honored guests, and members of the audience, please join me in recognizing these impressive individuals of the graduating class of 2015 for their accomplishments by offering a round of applause.